Welcome to the second Sunday in the month of March. How you all doing? I know that some of you have been on school break, and I hope you had a lovely time and are ready for more learning and exploring. This month, we're learning about amazing Bible stories you probably never heard before. If it's your first time here, you are welcome! Last week, we learned about a boy in the Bible named Eutychus who fell asleep and fell out of a window while Paul was speaking to the Christians in Troas. Paul talked for a very long time, and after a while, Eutychus must have gotten tired, and so he fell asleep. He was so sleepy that he fell right out of the window. He fell so hard he hurt himself bad and died. But Paul prayed for him and he came back to life. Sometimes accidents are directly our fault, and other times they're not. We aren't perfect people, and sometimes we make mistakes and accidents happen. God still loves us, and he turns the bad into good again. God is our strength when we are weak. He can help us do the right thing. When we pray to him for help, he listens to us. We can pray on behalf of other people too, just as Paul prayed for Eutychus. If it's your birthday this week, please stand and shout. Can you say how old you are going to be? Say it out loud. Awesome! Let's sing you this birthday song. We wish you a happy birthday, and we pray that this new year will be filled with celebration and joy. Have you ever used tools to build something up or to cut something down? What tools have you used? Like a pair of scissors? Do you know that some tools are as light as a feather and can float on water, while other tools are heavy and will sink all the way down when you put them in water? Can you mention other items apart from tools that can float on water? Things like balloon or a sheet of paper. What are some things that can sink in water? Can you mention a few? Yes, a coin, a key, or even a stone will sink in water. Do you know that in science, some things are considered to be impossible, e.g. getting back your raw ingredients from a baked cupcake? People study science and want to know what is and is not possible, but God can do the impossible. Imagine when the doctor says there is nothing more they can do to save a patient. Sometimes that patient can still be healed. Sometimes we don't understand how a problem can be fixed, but after praying to God, he gives us a solution. God can do anything. Nothing is impossible with God. Think for a second about the last small problem that you had. What did you do about this problem? Before we go into our story, now let's pray. Eyes closed and heads bowed. Father, we thank you for today. Even as we learn from your word, we ask that your word will help us to grow and become better and better every day. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you.
Our verse of the month is from Romans chapter 8, verses 28. It says, "And we know that God causes everything to work together for the good of those who love God and are called according to his purpose for them." Now go get your Bible and let's say it together. Ready? Romans chapter 8, verses 28. "And we know that God causes everything to work together for the good of those who love God and are called according to his purpose for them." This is an orangutan. Raise your hand if you have ever heard of this animal before. They live on the Southeast Asia islands. Orangutans climb trees and love to eat fruits like mangoes. Do you know that 50% of orangutans have broken bones due to falling out of trees on a regular basis? Believe it or not, it's true. Sometimes, the unlikely things are accidents, just like the fact that orangutans fracture their bones all the time. Have you ever watched funny home videos of people getting hurt? Sometimes it makes us laugh because it's so shocking, but really, it's a sad thing when someone gets hurt. You might try to do a jump and accidentally land on your back. Ouch! Why is it that accidents happen? Let's explore this a bit more. Sometimes, accidents happen when we're not careful or when we're not focusing on what we're doing. Sometimes, God wants to catch our attention when we sin. Let's talk a bit more about sin. Once sin entered the world, it allowed bad things to happen. Sometimes they are directly our fault, but sometimes accidents just happen to us. Either way, it's as a result of the fact that this world is not perfect. The good news is, God can even use accidents for our good. Someone who breaks their arm will have difficulty seeing how this could be a good thing. It might not be until a year later that they can see how God worked it for their good. Maybe they met a person in the hospital that became their best friend whom they never thought they would meet if it hadn't been for that accident. It is hard to accept bad things happening to us, but we can hold on to the promise that God makes all things good for those who love him. Have you ever heard the Bible story about the axe head that floated? Today, we're going to hear about it. The group of prophets said to Elisha, "The place where we meet with you is too small for us. Let us go to the Jordan River. There every man can get a pole and let's build a place there to live." Elisha said, "Go." One of them said, "Please go with us." Elisha said, "I will go." So he went with them. When they arrived at the Jordan, they cut down some trees. As one of them was cutting down a tree, the head of his axe fell. And he cried, "Oh my master, I borrowed that axe." Elisha asked, "Where did it fall?" The man showed Elisha the place. Then Elisha cut down a stick and threw it in the water. It made the iron axe head float. Elisha said, "Pick up the axe head." Then the man reached out and took it. That must have been frustrating to lose a friend's axe. How would you feel if you lost something that didn't belong to you? I would feel bad. Not to mention that it might be pretty expensive too. Sure, there are worse things that could happen. For instance, this man could have gotten hurt by the axe, but the fact that it is a small problem does not make it any less important to God. Sometimes people tell us that our problem is not a big deal, as if it doesn't matter. But it matters to God. God cares about us so much. God did a miracle through Elisha to make an axe head float so that the man could get it back. What an amazing thing to happen. Most items do not typically float around in our world because of gravity, especially stuff made from heavy metal like iron. Unless it's a balloon filled with helium or something very light like a feather, most objects fall to the ground. An axe is definitely a heavy item that would normally not float, but absolutely nothing is impossible with God. He is all-powerful. A big word that means all-powerful is omnipotent. This means that God can do anything. Do you ever feel like your problem is too small to ask God for help? Do you think God is too busy helping people with bigger problems? That simply isn't true. We learned earlier that God is all-powerful. This means He can do anything. There's something else God is. God is omnipresent. This big word means that God is everywhere. God is here and God is there all at the same time. He can't be too busy helping someone else because He's everywhere at the same time. Something else that I should mention is that God is love. God loves you and cares about you so much. He is with you and He wants to help you with all of your problems, big or small. So we've learned two big words today. Omnipresent, God is everywhere, and omnipotent, God is all powerful. There's one more thing I don't want us to overlook in the story. Let's not forget about Elisha. At the beginning of the story, his friends asked him to go with them. Elisha could have said no to them and sent them to do the work on their own. He instead supported them and went with them. When a man was upset about his problem of losing his axe, Elisha helped him. He had compassion for him and did not want to see his friend in distress. I brought this up to point out the way Elisha treated others. As a follower of God, we should always treat people the way Jesus does. It's important to love others, be respectful, caring, compassionate, and support others when they need us. God wants us to go to Him with our troubles, big or small. He also wants us to be there for others when they are in need. In the same way God cares about us, we can share that love with others. Everyone, stand up out of your seats for a minute. Repeat after me. God cares about me. Now turn to your neighbor and repeat after me. God cares about me. Now shout these words. God is love. Very good. This week, we have learned that God cares about us. He's not too busy helping someone else to help us. God is omnipresent, which means He is everywhere. God is omnipotent, which means He's all powerful. We should always go to our Heavenly Father for help because He loves us. There's no problem too big for God to help us with or too small for God to care about. We should care for other people and their problems just like Elisha did. To catch up with the full series and many other great teachings on our YouTube page at Elevation NG, just search for the Seeds playlist and I know you will learn a thing or two and be awesomely blessed. Every week we have a challenge. This week, our challenge is to think about what problems you have and remember that no problem is too small for God to care about. Write down one thing in your journal that you want God to help you with this week. You can email it to us at seeds@elevationng.org. Let us pray. Dear Father, thank you for caring about us. Help us to remember you can do anything and you are always present everywhere. Please help us with our problems and help us to love others the way that you love us. In Jesus' name, amen. Some people have written us to say that these teachings bless them and would like to give an offering to God. The different ways by which you can give are now displayed. Please note that this is optional. God bless you. Let's check out our pop quiz today. Ready? Set and go! What did the man lose in the water? The man lost an axe head. What is the name of the prophet that helped the man? Elisha is the prophet that helped him. How did Elisha help the man? Elisha cut a stick and threw it into the water, and it made the axe head float. What does omnipotent mean? God is all powerful. What does omnipresent mean? God is present everywhere. God cares about everyone, true or false. True, God cares about each and every one of us. Some problems are too big for God to solve, true or false. False! No problem is too big for God to solve. We should love others the way that God loves us. True or false? True! Why do you think we should go to God, even with our small problems? Because he's all-powerful and can solve any problem. What are some ways you can help your friend or siblings with their problems? By being there for them, by showing them you love them like God loves them. Remember, you can watch all these teachings as many times as you can. Till I see you next time with another impactful teaching, remember, God cares about me, God cares about you, and God is love. I love you, and God loves you more. Bye.